Well, firstly, I got invited to Japan when I was 14 by a show here that was sort of a showcase of talented children. And at 14 years old is when I became a pro skater. So they invited me to perform on the show. There were like kid bands and kid gymnasts and stuff like that. And I was scared because I had never really traveled internationally. And I definitely had never traveled without my parents. And they just sent me off to Japan. And there was a person here that was sort of my guide and my interpreter. And I didn't know anything about Japan. And I just fell in love with it. I loved the technology. I loved the people. I loved the food. It was like I was in a video game. It was literally like I came to visit a living video game. And I tried to come back every chance I could ever since. I mean, that was 35 years ago. When we would take family vacations, I would try to bring my kids if possible. And they end up loving it, and now they always ask to come back. And so when I got this chance to wear the Japan crate, my very first question was, well, did we get to go to Japan to pick out the stuff? And they said, absolutely, and bring your family. And I signed on right then. That was pretty much it. You know, didn't take a lot of twisting my arm. We're having a blast. I mean, you know, the arcades here are like, even the smallest, most basic arcade is a super treat compared to the stuff we have in the US. One of the things I would always do is come here and buy a bunch of weird candies and snacks from the convenience stores and bring them home for people to try. And when I saw what Japan Crate was doing, I was like, well, that's kind of what I used to do. Like, and I didn't ever think of it as something that I could experience at home. It's this fun surprise box every month, and it's like one of our family times, quality times, you know, is when we get to open the box and all try it and dare each other and laugh and make faces. And, I was super hyped to get to do one myself, to like curate a box and to pick out the right snacks. And I put a lot of thought into it, honestly. You know, I could have just done it sort of half-assed, but I did want to make it something that had a lot of variety, that with, you know, sweet and savory and weird and sour, and had a lot of help from my kids, and it was fun, so I'm really thankful I got to do it.